Where did she come from? What is her story? Now you can hear Dorothy Spalding's testimony in Dorothy's own words. This is a story of loss, hardship, struggle, redemption, and ultimately grace. Become a monthly partner in our vision to spread the good news of Jesus Christ and receive the CD of Dorothy's very own testimony. As this audio CD blesses you and builds your faith, you will be helping to write the next chapter of our story. So call today and pledge your monthly support. 803-278-3618 or 888-725-8033. Be sure to request this exciting CD. Watchman Broadcasting, television that changes lives.
Welcome to Buy the Book. I'm your host, Dorothy Spalding, and again today we have another great author.
Tune in to watch Buy the Book at 6 p.m. on Tuesday. Enjoy great in-depth interviews with some of the top authors of today. The following program is made possible by the faithful support of the partners of WBPI TV 49. Your financial gifts will enable us to continue bringing this program to you. From the studios of Watchman Broadcasting on the banks of the Savannah River, it's Club 36 with Dorothy and Russell Spalding. Tonight, uplifting ministry, testimonies, and live music, sharing the gospel to the CSRA and beyond. And now, your hosts for Club 36, Dorothy and Russell Spalding.
Welcome to Club 36. Thank you for joining us. We have a great program with you tonight. We have some friends from Florida, been friends for a long time, right? How long? Years.
Years.
You were pregnant with Jason.
So it's about 6 years, 5, 6 years.
Or yeah.
Or more.
Yeah, because I remember when you first came and I was so excited. Our little Spanish friends.
Amen.
And every time you come, you look a little different. This time we got a little thing going, what is this?
I know it.
Is that for you to
know
put
it.
On?
I don't know. You know him.
Yeah.
I knew it.
I knew it. You're always going to pull it.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. No color in his hair, though.
Yeah. He's back to normal.
He's
one of these preachers that you never know what you're going to see when you go to church on Sunday.
Amen.
Right, Jack?
Yes.
Jackie, isn't that right?
That's correct.
I mean, you don't know what you have when you go to bed at night. There's somebody different in your bed.
Yeah.
You never know. Well, that didn't sound good either, did it? I didn't mean it the way it sounded. But
yeah.
So we have Gershwin and Jacqueline Dorado, and they are from Kissimmee, Florida, and just dear friends and pastors of a Spanish church down there that's fastly growing, and we're just thrilled to have them. Welcome. What's new in your life?
Glad to be here. God is doing awesome things. I'm so happy. I am going to try to tell you, not laughing, but this year has started awesome.
That's
for us.
Great.
I will get into it a little later. And we just believe in God for greater things. And we're here, we're doing a conference in the city, so glad to be home. And every time we get the opportunity to be here with you, it's
That's
just
wonderful.
An honor. And this is the first station that opened the doors for us to be in TV. So we're always gonna be in our heart.
Well, we love you guys. And I know that they've got great testimonies. For the brand new viewers, because we are on AT&T UVerse.
Awesome.
So we have a lot of new viewers watching. And
awesome.
So for the brand new viewers, I want to hear a little of your testimony today. But we're going to start out the day with what God's put on your heart for this year.
Yes.
Because I think it's so important that people know the different pastors, because it's funny, it's pretty much all the same.
Mm-hmm.
What God puts on their hearts.
Yes. Yes, it's awesome. Every time a new year is coming, we like to go into our prayer closet and pray and seek direction from the Lord. I believe that He works in times and seasons.
Mm-hmm.
So He prepares everything for us. We just have to obey it and walk that He has laid for us. And one of the things that we felt in the spirit, I remember I was praying, I believe it was last summer. And one morning, the Lord woke me up like at 4 or 5 in the morning, and I hear His voice so clear. He told me 2014 is going to be a year of fulfillment and accomplishments. I share with the church, and I knew right there and there when your vision, it's a body as a whole. Vision, you know that is not only for your church, it's for the church.
For the church.
Exactly. So I share that, you know, the words of the Lord with my wife and started preaching about it, you know, directing the church in that direction, sharing with my pastor's friends, with our bishop and all people that we know. And of course, my wife that loves to study. We've been studying the Hebrew language for the last 10 years.
You have?
Yes. So
that's wonderful. Every You're getting
time, ready. Yes. Every time we are going to go into a new year, we like to read and go to the Hebrew meaning. And you know, Hebrew is so awesome. It has 72 levels in the language, and we still in a few. It's such a mystery. It's so complex. It's so awesome. Every time you go in there, you dig something new in the same thing that you were studying before. So she started, you know, digging, if we can say it that way, and what was coming for this year. And it was so aligned with what the Lord told me.
And what did he tell you?
And he told me year of fulfillment.
Yeah, you said
and
that.
Accomplishment. And this year, she's going to get into that. It means open door.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
So if the door is opened, the passage is open for him to fulfill and for you to accomplish everything that he has tell you and he has prophesied to you. So we're just so excited. Church is growing. Our life is growing as a couple. We're traveling more than ever. I mean, it's just amazing. We just came back home on Monday from Puerto Rico. And then I gave a Bible study that we're doing about the Holy Spirit in the church. And then we were just out on the road on Thursday. So that's how we are at this moment.
Well, what happens on Sunday when you're not there?
I have good leaders, good pastors.
Isn't that wonderful?
That we have, you know, prepared.
That gives them an opportunity.
We have trained. We believe in the apostolic ministry, the real apostolic ministry, which is training people
in
the ways and exposing them like Jesus did with the disciples. He taught them and then he exposed them to do the job.
Yeah.
We're not afraid. We know where we're going, who we are, and we know our spiritual sons and daughters. So the church is well covered on Sundays. As a matter of fact, last Sunday, I had so many testimonies of people testifying how good was the preaching, was the word. And what I get is happy, excited that one of the people that I've been training with my wife is having, you know, all that blessing.
That's
it's
awesome.
Just the heart of the Father, you know. Just the heart of the Father. We love what God is doing, and this is the year of open doors.
Yeah.
It is. I don't know if you want to share a little bit of agenda let.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're going to do that. We get back.
Okay.
We're
going to
start up. As soon as we get back,
Definitely.
You may want to have your note, paper, and pencil. I always have one where I am. You never know what they say that you want to write down. So always have that on Club 36. You need to just have a pad of paper and pencil laying there so you can jot some things down. You know, when you go to church, if you take your notebook and paper and just jot things down, a scripture or whatever, and then during the week go back over it, it will make a huge, huge difference. So we challenge you with that. And I know you're going to enjoy this program today. We'll be back in just a minute. We're going to go to the dancers. These are your dancers. And, you know, I was telling Heather, I said, oh, the music is so good. I said, what happened? You know, they just had such great music. And she says, it's a CD. They're dancing. So you're going to enjoy this good music and dancing as well. We'll be back in just a minute.
Oh, because of a call.
journey of Watchman Broadcasting began in 1995. After 8 miracle-filled years of walking the cross across America, Dorothy and Russell Spalding felt the prompting of God to begin a Christian television station in Augusta, Georgia. Upon returning from a ministry trip, the Spaldings decided to drive back home through Augusta, Georgia, just to verify that they indeed were being pulled to that city. After driving through Augusta, the couple knew that God was getting ready to place them here. With their commitment to God made to come to Augusta and less than $100, Dorothy and Russell began to work out of a hotel room on Washington Road so as to raise awareness and community involvement in the area. One obstacle had to be overcome: where to house the vision of the future network. Having secured the tower site, Dorothy and Russell began driving around to find a suitable location for the studios. They drove up to a building on Knox Avenue in North Augusta. While sitting in the parking lot, they felt that they had found the place. Their faith was put to the test immediately when the owner quoted the monthly price at $7,000. With another figure in their heart, they went to return the keys after viewing the building. They then asked the owner if they could hold a one-time event in the building on July the 21st of 1995. Calls were made and invitations sent. Thus, the stage was set for open house. Just before the event, the owner of the building agreed to the event and a $2,000 a month figure that Dorothy Spalding had had in her heart. After trading and bartering for weeks, preparations were complete for the big night and the filming of the very first Club 36 on July the 21st, 1995. With pastors, fellow believers, community leaders, and special guests all gathered at a still fairly empty building, the vision for the future worldwide ministry began to be revealed. Opening night was a complete success. However, later that night, the initial owners of the television license pulled the Spaldings aside and informed them that participating in the vision of raising up Augusta, Georgia would be too big for them to participate in. With another test of their commitment to God's mandate, Dorothy and Russell Spalding stood firm and asked if they could raise the station by faith. The owner of the license replied, yes. After concluding a successful opening night, the next obstacle for the very young ministry was to get on the airways. The transmitter was in place, but the device needed to send the signal from the studios to the tower was yet to be purchased. The STL, or Studio Transmitter Link, which was needed, was at a hefty price tag of $8,000. Dorothy contacted the owners of the license and asked if they could help, but found out that they could not. Not sure how to resolve the situation, Dorothy and Russell prayed for wisdom and came into agreement that the need would be met. Dorothy then received a call from a gentleman that asked what the station needed. Dorothy's response was $8,000. The gentleman then replied, "You've got it." From that very moment forward, miracle after miracle began to take place. From pastors to local businesses and ministries, materials and labor began to pour in. From lumber to paint, furniture to equipment, support came from everywhere. Sets began to take form, nightly productions became the norm, and lives began to be changed. Month after month, year after year, the station, TV 36, saw expansion and growth. In 2001, with an FCC requirement, the 36-channel license was moved from Augusta and given to another city. Dorothy Spalding quickly called the station lawyers in Washington, D.C. to ask what needed to happen. The lawyers gave specific instructions, and Dorothy followed them. As with previous years, God made a way. The station went from TV 36 to TV 49, moving from 1,000 watts of power to 150,000 watts of power. Increasing the potential viewership, TV 49 not only expanded with its over-air coverage, but with local cable systems as well, being picked up by 3 of the 4 major cable systems in the CSRA. Watchman Broadcasting's desire to reach the world with unique Christian programming began to take place in 2002 with the launch of Rock House Cafe locally. Then in 2003, Rock House went national, and finally in 2004, international. Following Rockhouse Cafe came By the Book in 2003, going national that same year and international in 2004. Both Rockhouse Cafe and By the Book continue to make their mark to this day, having received multiple Angel, Telly, and Davey Awards. A further test of the resolve of the ministry came in 2006 when the station's transmitter was hit and all but destroyed by lightning. Functioning with only 10% power for the next 4 months, God began to work another miracle for Watchman Broadcasting to purchase one of the industry's best transmitters. The new transmitter enabled TV49 to transmit its signal stronger and further than ever. Then in 2009, the mandate from the FCC came down from Washington, D.C. This mandate offered another chance for God's faithfulness to be shown. In January 2009, with not all finances raised, deadlines were moved, and God placed it upon the hearts of many across the CSRA and America to make sizable donations so that TV49 could complete its FCC-mandated digital upgrade. And so the story has been with Watchman Broadcasting and the founders, Dorothy and Russell Spaulding. Miracles, signs, and wonders. Every time it would look like failure would be the final word, God always stepped in and made a way. Why? With over 15 years of ministry, over 12,000 recorded salvations, 3,600 prevented suicides, and multiple hundreds of thousands of ministry calls, answers that question. Watchman Broadcasting, 15 years later, and still television that changes lives.
And we are television that changes lives. Praise God for what He has done. You know, the Bible says in Habakkuk 2, verse 2 and 3 and 4, but He says, write the vision. Now see, every time we show you this, we're writing the vision. We just keep writing the vision and show you and make it plain on tablets that he may run that readeth it. Well, if you're a television station, you put it on video so that those that watch it can run with it. And that's why we show you these videos over and over and over again, to show you, look at the vision, what God has done, where He's taking us from. He took us from glory to glory to glory to glory.
Amen.
And then it says, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. The vision of the food lion, which we're working on. By the way, did you see we're getting a new roof?
Yes, beautiful.
The vision is for appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie, though it tarry, though it takes a little time, don't give up. So whatever the vision is God's putting in your life, write it down. Make it so people can see it. Talk about it. Show it over and over and over again. And what happens is exactly what God's putting you guys to talk about.
Yes, yes.
Talk about what you said about the past.
I started this new year preaching off, right off Philippians chapter 3, verse 13. Uh-huh. And the easy to read Bible says it like this: brothers and sisters, I know that I still have a long way to go, but there is one thing I do. I forget what is in the past, and I try as hard as I can to reach the goal before me. I keep running hard towards the finish line to get the prize that is mine, because God has called me through Christ Jesus. And I was sharing with the church and everywhere I go that for you to be able to embrace the future, you have to let go of the past.
Yeah.
You know, I know what Jesus thought about the old new wine and old skins. You know, you have to be able to let God do something new in your life. And I come to find out in ministry that the worst enemy of the new is the old. We think we know what we're doing. We think that things are going to work the same way from the past. But in reality, God wants to do something new.
Yes.
God has been setting up the church. He's been setting us up to do something new. And last week, I believe on last Sunday, 2 weeks ago, my wife was teaching about this open door year. It's a generation of double.
Double.
We're going to do double. We're going to take what the past generation took to a place and take it to the next level, and then the next generation, it's not about us, it's about doing what God called us to do. Open doors, agenda lit.
You know, it's wonderful that God has, this is the year of open door.
Yes.
That God has provided us an open door.
Yes.
So that we can go ahead and just start proclaiming things and believing God for them.
Amen.
And they will come to pass.
Amen. Remember, the last year was the eye on the camel.
Oh, last year.
Camels,
yes,
came.
The camels,
huh?
Came.
They and got, this year is the eye at the door.
The door, yeah.
Which means open doors. So God sent the camels to prepare everything we need, and now He has opened up the door for us to be able to have access
to it.
To it. And that's what He's doing. What is in your heart, honey?
You know, this man, a lot of times people are saying that, well, I saw it happen for you, but what about me?
Yes.
Don't quit and don't give up. It's not done. It's 3 years. Don't give up.
Yes, yes,
you know,
yes.
Personally, I didn't see it like I saw it at the station. Mm-hmm. But does it mean it doesn't work? Mm-hmm. It does work. I'm telling you, God listens to every conversation.
Amen.
And when we were trying to figure out, we were eating lunch, Tamara, Chris, and I, and we were trying to figure out this year, what is this year? And you know what I said? I just wish I could talk to a Jewish rabbi. Within 5 minutes, I got a call on my cell. Now, a lot of times at lunch, I won't open my cell. And it said, from Israel. Answered it.
Amen.
Rabbi Shmuel, you're calling me? He's never called me before,
wow.
Ever. And he said, I just said I wanted to talk to a rabbi. And he's not just a rabbi. He's a rabbi scribe.
Wow.
Ooh.
And this is how bad God wants you to know this is the year of the open door.
Yes.
Because I said, what does this year mean? And he told me.
Agenda let.
Yeah. And he said, to gather the pots. And when he said that, I wasn't quite sure what that meant about gathering the pots. But when I read the scripture over and over again, this is what I saw. You gather the pots, you bring them into your house. So in other words, I'm expecting big. I'm gathering big. I put them in my house. What do? I shut the door. When does the Holy Ghost give you ideas? When you're in God's presence, you shut the door.
Yes.
Then awesome. He tell you to put the tallit over you, make the closet and shut the door and spend time with Him.
Yes.
And when you do, He's going to give you visions and provisions.
Amen.
But and see that then she could fill her pot with oil after she shut the door. It never ran out. She filled those pots with oil.
Amen.
But I believe that the Lord showed me that because that rabbi called me. I mean, what are the chances? He's never called me. I've known him for years. He never called me.
God is good.
But
God is
good. Look at God. I didn't even know He had my phone number. But He said, Dorothy, are you all right? All of a sudden, you came heavy on my heart. Just look at God. Praise he puts God. Me heavy on the heart of a rabbi.
Amen.
Well, He'll do the same for you.
Amen.
He will. Just don't give up on it. Watch the profession of your mouth, the confession of your mouth.
Yes.
Because it will come. Now you go ahead.
Amen, amen.
Well, there was two words that God put in my spirit in the beginning of the year. One was access, and the other one was release. So there's things that we haven't been able to access that the last years has been limiting us. You know, the camels were coming, but there were still limitations. There were still things that were holding us back. But because Ayin Dalet is this year, which is I see the door. So when you say I, the I has to see the door, then when you go biblically, the door is Jesus. So when you look, when your eye is focused on Jesus, then you'll be able to access the door. You know, the door has been there. He says, whoever knocks shall be open unto you. So you need to be able to, like you say, go into maybe a dimension, do things in the past that you haven't done. So you can access what God has been wanting for you because the door is there. Now, I could see a door. But doesn't mean the door is going to open automatically. I can't use my eye vision and be like Superman and look at the door and make the door open. No, I have to go walk towards the door. And then when I get to the door, I have to turn the knob. And then when I turn the knob, I have to push the door. So a lot of us in the last year, December, you know, we're at the door. But now this year, the door is open for us. So we need to push in. We need to access. And once you go through the door, like you say, the door is there. She shut the door. Now you go through the door, and there's going to be release from heaven, supernatural. That's where the opportunities, where that's where the release of favor, canceling debt is coming in. That's where the limitations that happened to you last year is not going to be able to go through the door with you, because that door is going to be shut. The door that he opens, no man can shut. And whatever he shuts, no man can open. Yeah. So whatever has been limiting you, the giant that has been limiting you, once you access through the door, the release of the supernatural God is ready for us to be able to do things that we haven't been able to do before in the last years. I think this is the time of the church. This is why he says, I see the door. Let your natural eye